Welcome, everyone. All right, let's get started with our breathing. Place your feet a comfortable distance apart, hands on the lower abdomen, lips lightly sealed, teeth gently meshed together. Allow your eyes to close. And let's start focusing on that deep, relaxed breathing. Breathe in, feel your abdomen go out. And as you breathe out, feel it come back in. Breathe in deeply. Breathe out slowly. Be relaxed. Each breath, begin to imagine a cascade of relaxation flowing down the body from the top of your head all the way down to the bottoms of your feet. Feel your face and jaw relax. And shoulders relax. Chest and upper back relax. Shoulders and arms feel heavy. Feel the flow of relaxation through your waist, into your hips, through the thighs and the backs of your legs. Allow your knees to soften. Feel your calf muscles relax and your ankles relax and the bottoms of your feet. Relax. Breathe in deeply. Breathe out slowly. Be relaxed. The next time that you breathe out, go ahead and open your eyes. And if you're wondering, that meditation sounds the same every time. It is, and there's a reason for it, for me anyway. It's not laziness. it's by saying the same kind of guided wording through it. Hopefully, about the more times you hear it, you will start to remember it yourself, so that at any point, if you want to take yourself through that cascade of relaxation, you can take a moment, you can pause, and those words and cues will be there for you. So that's why I like to stay consistent with the verbiage. It's to try to kind of lay that, like the life skills, to lay that that wording down so that you have access to it for yourself whenever you need it. So with that, let's go ahead and begin our first posture, embracing horse. Separate the feet shoulder width apart. Remember, turn those toes in slightly so the outside edges of the feet become parallel. Round those knees out, don't let them collapse in. Get your tuck, lean forward, slightly. Circle the arms back and around. I feel like this is a good reminder to keep some alertness through the fingers. They're not stiff. This is kind of a beginner posture, like hard. It's not hard, it's relaxed, but it's not wilted either. So keep a rounded aliveness through the fingers, even though I'm not tense. gaze is kind of out in front of you between your fingers. Just a reminder, if anybody is new joining us today, you should feel like your thighs are working, but you should not have any joint pain, not knee pain, ankle pain, hip pain, anything like that. So if you have any of that, back out of the posture, try to come back into it, and let us know, whether it's email, Facebook message, however you can get in touch with us. That you've got that issue and we can try to help kind of triage that. It's usually an alignment issue that we can help with. Thigh burn though, you're doing it right. Posture number two. Today I'm probably going to instruct a little bit less than I have been, but if you don't already know, we have a playlist of all the previous lessons that we've done. So if you get to a posture and you wish that I had said more about it, you can go back to the playlist and all the previous lessons that we've done and kind of spoken a lot more about the postures. But today I kind of want to just get the flow a little bit, so I'm going to talk a little bit less. All right, so ride the wild horse, middle stance. Inhale, exhale, small stance, begin, inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Wide stance, shoulder width. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Inhale. Exhale. Posture number three, playing guitar. Left toes out, wide angle, shift. Set the right heel down. Other side. With the lack of the reduced instruction today, what I'd like for you to focus on as you move through these postures is check how much you're fidgeting and try to dial that down a little bit. See if you can find the stillness in these postures. Of course, it takes a little bit to get into it where you feel like you've got it. But then from there, resist the urge to keep fussing with, you know, your alignment. Try to settle into it. Number four, the compass. Reach up and to the left. One, two, three, dragon's lead from C. Get into that walking lunge. Start with left foot forward. And down for a stretch. Circle with hands. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And down for a stretch. Bump circle with the hands. Inhale. Inhale. And release. Posture number six. Rhinoceros gazes at the moon. Feet shoulder width apart. Embracing horse type legs. Circle the arms around. Left hand on top. And begin. Center. Other side. Center. One more time. Center. Other side. And release. Shake it out if you need to. Posture number seven, Ryan the Tiger. Start facing the left. Remember about keeping that tuck. And step out. Thank you. Push off. Other side. Push off. Other side. And step out. Push off. Other side. And push off. Number 8. Phoenix spreads wings. We're going to talk about this one in detail in a few minutes. Direction. Posture number 9, hit the tiger. Let's go to the left side first. Remember, you're going to step mostly sideways, a little bit forward. Step out only as far as you can to push off in one movement. And step. Turn. Push off. Again. Last one on this side. And push off. Other side. Step out. Push off. Again. Push off. posture 10, owl turns head. Still use your legs. Don't get to stand totally upright yet. Still bend down, get that tuck, engage those thighs. Hands on the hips, head suspended, and turn to the left. Straighten the legs, lower the hands, circle the arms up, inhale. Press the palms down to exhale. Excellent work. As always, if you have any questions about any of the postures that you've seen, you can go back to the previous lessons, and particularly the black sash training portion. We've been going posture by posture into kind of the deep details. Or if it's a specific question pertaining to yourself or an alignment issue, like I said, let us know, and we will either get back with you personally or address it anonymously in the class once we have the information. And with that, let's go ahead and bow out of our basic training. We follow the five hearts: faith, respect, perseverance, patience, and humility. And